most websites start in a design tool like Figma, but this changes everything. Framer just released a feature called Design Pages, and it might be the reason you never open Figma again. I'm Phil Pallen, a brand strategist. Today, we're exploring Design Pages, Framer's new freeform canvas for designing and building websites in one place. This video is sponsored by Framer, but this feature genuinely caught my attention. You can now sketch, experiment, build layouts, and publish all in one tool. Let me show you what's new. I'm going to show you how I designed a new site for a leather goods brand completely inside Framer. Let's start with this canvas. This is a design page inside Framer. So it's a freeform space made for designers to think, sketch, explore ideas visually. You're not limited by layout rules or grid systems right away. Just drop in your ideas and start designing. There's no need to structure things up front or worry about responsiveness. You can focus entirely on creative direction. All the tools you'd expect are here, and they're easy to access right along the top here. You've got frames, text for typography, shapes like rectangles or ovals, and vectors for custom icons or illustrations. You can also add images, build with gradients, and even create advanced masks if you want more control over layering. Everything is drag and drop. It works exactly how you'd expect. Resize objects, move them around, adjust layers. Framer gives you pixel level precision and creative flexibility without slowing you down. Now, one of my favorite things about design pages is how easy it is to compare variations. You don't have to toggle layers or create separate files, just explore right on the canvas. Let's hop back in and I will show you. To refine the hero section for Oliver Cameron, I duplicated the header and a few times here to test different font pairings, layout tweaks. Since design pages are completely freeform, I can adjust spacing, colors, typography without touching breakpoints or structure. I like this setup because it makes it really easy to visualize options side by side, choose whatever feels right, whether I'm designing solo or showing variations to a client. And when something clicks, you can instantly promote any part of your design to a fully functional website. No exporting, no rebuilding, no compromises. Just click and publish. And if you are short on time or you just want to get inspired, Framer's built-in AI tools are seriously impressive. Let me show you how I can use Wireframer to jumpstart this brand. I like to think of design pages and Wireframer as companions. They support the same creative process, exploration first, structure second. With Wireframer, I just describe what I need, like a portfolio or a landing page, and Wireframe creates multiple options side by side. This is perfect for exploring structure and flow quickly. Once I find a layout I like, I can right-click and convert it to a responsive web page, similar with design pages. This is by far the easiest way I've found to go from loose ideas to solid direction, especially when you're working fast or collaborating with clients. Now, design pages aren't just about layout, they're also great for visuals too. Design pages aren't just about layout, they're powerful for styling too. Here I'm refining the look of Oliver Cameron's homepage using Framer's built-in tools. Let me mention that the color picker supports P3 color profiles, which means gradients can feel richer and more vibrant if you've got one, especially useful when you want your site to feel premium, which I do in this case. And I could also use the scale tool, hint, just press K on your keyboard to bring this up, and this will resize the section proportionately without messing up the layout. And then with just a few clicks, I can browse Framer's curated fonts, icon sets instantly to elevate this design. Not placeholders, these are production-ready assets that make your site feel considered from the very first draft. You can also use design pages to create content outside of your site, like social assets or client deliverables. You can use design pages for more than just web design. In this example, I'm creating a set of visuals for Oliver Cameron's upcoming product launch. Exporting is super simple. Just select any frame, click export. You can use this for Instagram posts, ad creatives, pitch decks, really anything that your brand needs. And it even supports animated and vector exports. That's perfect if you're working with motion, iconography, things like that. Instead of jumping around between tools, everything happens here inside one canvas. That's something you'll definitely benefit from. Now, here's one feature you won't find in most design tools, 3D transforms. Let's take this handbag image and give it some depth. In just a few clicks, I can rotate the layer, adjust perspective, make it feel more dynamic, all without touching code. What's impressive here is how smooth this is. You can layer these effects to create interactive, responsive visuals that stand out. This is something that you can't do with Figma or Sketch. Framer gives you full 3D control right inside the browser. So that is Design Pages and a look at some complementary features in Framer that I think make this one of the best options on the market nowadays for a truly custom website. Think of it as your new playground for designing, iterating, and building all in one place. Whether you're mocking up a site, crafting visuals, or testing layouts, it's fast, flexible, and it's free. Try it out with a link below and use code PHIL for a free month of Framer Pro. Let me know in the comments what kind of website or project will you build with Design Pages. Subscribe for more of my tutorials, tips, and tools like this one. A huge thanks to Framer for being an awesome partner to work with. I'm Phil Pallen. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.